Absorption happens in the nucleus. Processing also happens in the nucleus. That's why it is the matured already or the functional RNA that eventually is transported into the cytoplasm. Transcription is highly selective. What does it mean? All cells in the body possess the same set of genes. Why is it that they behave differently? To make our studying of medicine more difficult. Why is it that you have a liver cell that functions? Why is it you have the muscle cell? The same set of genes. Because of selection of which part of the gene need to be expressed. Okay? So depending now on what are the protein present in the cell, then there is that particular function. Okay? You have to appreciate that and you have to know that. So for the biochemical differentiation of the different tissues, so the primary transcript is inactive. It has to undergo modification, to become functional. So, the precursor, of course, are your ribonucleoside triphosphate. Okay? There is no primer, there is no proofreading, but it doesn't mean that there is no fidelity. The triplex strand is the non-coding strand, while the opposite of the DNA, double-stranded molecule is actually the coding strand because it looks the same as the mRNA except that it has a T instead of a U. You understand this one? So that is the promoter side, that is the terminator side or element. It is read out from 3 prime to 5 prime and always the process goes from 5 prime to 3 prime. Okay. So any part of that can be transcribed. It depends. Okay. Let's take a look at the prokaryotic first. We have a lot of protein and enzymes involved in replication. For transcription, there's only one big important enzyme, and that is your DNA-dependent RNA polymerase, or your RNA, holoenzyme. Okay? So it is made up of a core complex, that is the one, that is the zinc, and then you have the sigma factor. So two of them. So that is how it works. Okay, so first is template binding, then initiation, then promoter clearance, then elongation, then termination. One RNAP may transcribe the same template, and they are phased and spaced. Okay, so there is enough room for that to happen. So template binding. So the RNAP holoenzyme binds, it scans. First there is the close complex. Okay. Recognizes and binds to the promoter with high fidelity, and that is the function of the sigma factor in the enzyme that recognizes and allow the enzyme to bind to the promoter site. So this will ensure accurate initiation, that is the fidelity there. Okay? So initially it is closed, then it will open. So the closed complex, and this is now the open complex. And it will now allow initiation to happen. So the RNA polymerase will read the template from 3 prime to 5 prime and synthesize it from 5 prime to 8 prime. The first nucleotide is a purine. So it is either A or G. And it is, of course, at the 5 prime end of the primary transcript, and it is a triphosphate. So the initiation site will then become the polymerization site. When there is 10 to 20 stretch of the ribonucleotide that is formed, the sigma factor will be released. And then it will lead to promoter clearance. So it will get away now from the promoter site. Okay? Until such time when it reaches the terminator part or element, then hydrolysis will happen to release your primary transcript. So elongation, let's take a closer look at elongation. So we said there is only one enzyme, the RNA polymerase. So since to expose the continuing part of the template of that particular strand of the DNA, then it has to separate. That's why it has an unwindase activity to get access to the template. Since there is tightening that will happen via that, so there is the topoisomerase. So how is the release of the torsional strain? It will need to function. It will need to cut to release the tension, but of course you need to seal it back. Okay, so knitting and resealing or ligation. The same here. Then of course there should be a rewinding of the template that has been read and transcribed already. So we also have what we call the transcription bubble, wherein it will form about 20 base pair per polymerase. Termination will happen in two ways. The presence of the inverted interrupted repeat, or your hyphenated, so your palindrome, making up a lot of this sequence, or the presence of another factor, the wrong protein or the wrong factor, which is actually a terminator protein. It has a very long name. ATP dependent RNA stimulated helicase recognizes the termination element and bring about termination of transcription and the release of your nascent RNA. There is no picture in the chapter. Eukaryotic, there are three types of RNA polymerase depending on what RNA is going to be transcribed. Okay? 1, 2, 3. This one is actually the 45S RNA. Okay? Rather than calling them pre RNA for a filter, this is the 45S RNA. This one is your heterogeneous HN RNA. So the HNRNA is modified to become the mRNA. Okay? Clear? Okay. They are differentiated from each other by their sensitivity to alpha amanitin. One is insensitive, two is highly sensitive, while three is intermediate. So this is in Harvard. So each type of tRNA polymerase is a complex of many polypeptide subunits, as many as 14. Then it requires the binding of transcription factors to locate the promoter and orient the polymerase correctly. So transcription factors are very important for transcription. So you have your basal expression and regulated expression. Okay. So in the promoter side, you have the TATA and the CAAT. This is where, this is how frequent. Do you understand the meaning of the arrow? Somebody will take over.
Tung gay samurai. You got only samurai in the description.
Enhancer elements, so these are called elements. So the regulated expression can be upstream or downstream. Where is the structural gene here? It will start here. Okay. Take note of the role of certain hormones that play a role in regulating transcription and translation. So that part of the DNA is known as your hormone response element. Okay. The eukaryotic transcription complex. It's a complex apparatus, 50 unique proteins. It provides for accurate and regulatable transcription. It means your polymerase plus plus plus